Very good morning, friends. As you remember that I had made one video upon the different periods of English literature for your proper clarity, because it always gives a kind of confusion to students when a particular period begins and when does it end. But today I'll be adding something more in that, because there were a lot of demands, sir, how to remember the different periods along with some famous writers, we forget it. And definitely, which I'm going to tell you today, will lay the very foundation of your preparation for the NET or such examinations of the same nature. Because unless and until, friends, you know the different periods of English literature, you will be just like a vacuum. There will always be void. How much novel you read, how much poems you read, it hardly matters if you do not have the proper foundation of English literature, and it cannot be done without the proper knowledge of the different periods of English literature. Now, what I have done today, that I'll be also giving you some of the prominent names, which work like a hygroscopic nuclei. Around them only there are other writers who were coming together and clubbing together. So I'll be discussing the famous, some of the famous or pioneering or the flag bearers of certain of every period, so that it will be a kind of help to you, and it will also develop your basic knowledge along with the period and some famous writers. So friends, let me begin. As you remember that the periods of English literature, you have to begin your study. You just remember first word OMR, yeah, O-M-R. O-M-R. O-M-R sheet is very popular nowadays for every examinations in the electronic method. So O stands for Old English Period. That is also known as Anglo-Saxon period, which begins from 450 to 1066 AD. And the famous writers of this period, Old English period, is A Square C. E Square C is also one Einstein formula, but EM something like that. But this is what? A Square C. A Square means A, first A for Alfric, and second for the Alfred King, and C for Cadmon. These three were the prominent figures of Old English period. A Square C, Alfric, Alfred King, and Cadmon. Now, the next M, O-M-R, O ho gaya, M. M stands for Middle English period. And this Middle English period begins from 1066 to 1500 AD. So the famous writers of this period is BC Square G. B for Bacon, C for Caxton, C again for Chaucer, G for Gower, John Gower. Okay, so this is how you have to remember. First Old English period, A Square C, Alfric, Alfred King, Cadmon. Now Middle English period begins from 1066 to 1500, and the famous authors is BC Square G, Bacon, Roger Bacon, then not Francis Bacon, you remember Francis Bacon is of Elizabethans, you know. So Roger Bacon, Caxton has first, he has established the printing press, you know, so that is why he is very important. Chaucer, Geoffrey Chaucer, C, and then G for John Gower. Now OMR ka last R, that R stands for Renaissance or Early Modern period. So that begins from 1500 to 1660. So this is how OMR, Old English period, Middle English period, and the Renaissance or Early Modern period begins. And now we will see the Renaissance in detail, the Renaissance or Early Modern period, that is of covering 160 years from 1500 to 1660. Now how will you remember the different ages which come under this Renaissance period? because the Renaissance period, as you can see, is a long period of 160 years. So there are four different ages, you know. So I had told you in the last video about Eliza Carr Company. This is a keyword that you should remember. Eliza Carr Co. You can see in red it is written. So Eliza Carr LE stands for Elizabethan Age. That Elizabethan Age begins from 1558 to 1603, that is of 45 years. Then JA stands for Jacobean Age, that is from 1603 to 1625, that is of 22 years. Then CAR stands for Carolin Age, that begins from 1625 to 1649, that is of 24 years. And now then Company stands for Co for Commonwealth, that is the Puritan interregnum, that begins from 1649 to 1660, that is of 11 years, right? Now let us see Elizabethan, the Renaissance number one, Elizabethan Age. Elizabethan Age, as you can see, LE is written on a red and JAR Company is in a green, because I am going to discuss Elizabethan Age, the first age under that falls under Renaissance period. That is from 1558 to 1603, that is of 45 years. Now this Renaissance or this Elizabethan age that falls under Renaissance period, this age is popularly known for drama. Or we can also say that it is an age of William Shakespeare, or it is an age of University Waits. And the famous writers you can remember through BBC. B for Bacon, B for Ben Jonson, and C for Christopher Marlowe. And then Triple S stands for Sidney Spencer Shakespeare, right? And then Sir Walter Raleigh is also a very important name, so I have written it separately. So if you have to remember the Elizabethan age, and then you have to remember tenure, that is of 1558 to 1603, the duration. Now it is known as a drama. William Shakespeare was the prominent figure of this age, and the university wits like George Peel, George Green, Thomas Nash, they were the famous, you know, dramatists. But if you have to choose some of the important writers, this is BBC. You can remember B for Bacon, Francis Bacon, then B for Ben Jonson is also a very important figure, and C for Christopher Marlowe, the dramatist, that is very powerful dramatist of that time, who is also known for Seneca and Tragedy. And then there are triple S for Sidney Spencer Shakespeare. So this is how. Now in under the Renaissance period, the second age is Jacobean, Eliza Carr JA for Jacobean Age. Now Jacobean age begins from 1603 to 1625. So this is also why it is known as a Jacobean, because in Jacob is the, you know, in Latin Jacobus, you know, becomes James in English. And that time there was a reign of King James I. So for Jacob, James I, you know, we know this period as Jacobean age. Now how to remember the important names? Now for the prose writers, you can remember one name, Babu James Don. Babu James Don. So this Babu ka jo ba hai, that is for Bacon. Bu jo hai, that is for Burton. James jo hai, that is for King James, who translated Holy Bible. And Don for John Donne. So that is how we can remember the different prose writers of this period, Babu James Don. So Francis Bacon has written very popular essays. Then Boo, that is Robert Burton, has written Anatomy of Melancholy. Then there is James, that King James has translated Holy Bible. And John Donne has written a lot of sermons, you know, and that is also a very prominent figure in metaphysical poetry. Now age of tragedies, it is there in the Jacobean age, the basic, you know, the prominent literary discovery was nothing but the tragedies, and most of the famous tragedies were written in during this period. Like William Shakespeare has written all his tragedies in this period, then John Donne has written, and Ben Jonson, then Michael Drayton, then Thomas Middleton, you know, then Sir Francis Beaumont and John Fletcher, John Webster. These were the famous writers who have, you know, written lot of you know, eternal tragedies that we can never forget. Now comes the third, that is, we have discussed Eliza Carr, Company of the Renaissance. Now I am going to discuss Carr, that is for Caroline age. And as you know, that in Latin, Carolus is known in English for Charles I. So there was a reign of Charles I. So that is why this age is also known as Caroline age. Now we can see that this was the time of the English Civil War, fought between the supporters of the king known as Cavaliers and the supporters of Parliament known as Roundheads. So these were clear-cut two groups during that time, you know. So the famous writers of the Caroline age that falls under the third phase of the Renaissance, the famous writer, how will you remember that? Like in Hindi, ek word aap yaad karo, har vakt brown bartan. Har vakt brown bartan mein koi bachcha kha raha hai. To har vakt jo hai, that is for Herbert, George Herbert, you know. And Brown stands for Sir Thomas Brown, who was a very famous writer of this age. Burton stands for Robert Burton, who were all religious poets. And religiosity is also related with Brown, you can say, or the saffron. So Herbert Brown Burton, that will give you a kind of, you know, a group of writers you can remember very easily. Herbert means Herbert. Brown means Thomas Brown, Burton is Robert Burton. Now, the associated with court were also the Cavalier poets, and the Cavalier poets, the famous Cavalier, how will you remember their names? So I have designed it. When I was a student, I was thinking in that pattern. So you know, you can see on a screen, Rick is there, jo ghas rakha rehta, that is also known as Rick. सो मैंने एक दे दिया, और इस रिक के अराउंड आप इमेजिन करो कि लव चल रहा है, शक हो रहा है, थॉमस कैर अपने कार से वहाँ पहुँचा है एंड रॉबर्ट हर रिक वहाँ पर पहुँचा हुआ है. सो हाउ डू रिमेंबर रिचर्ड लवलेस, लव फॉर लवलेस, एक लवलेस नाम में लव छुपा हुआ है. सर जॉन सकलिंग में शक छुपा हुआ है. इन थॉमस कैरो में कार छुपा हुआ है, सीआर. एंड रॉबर्ट हेरिक में रिक तो छुपा ही हुआ है, हर भी छुपा हुआ है. सो इट इज हिडन. सो दैट इज हाउ यू शुड रिमेंबर रिचर्ड लवलेस, जॉन सकलिंग, थॉमस कैरो एंड देयर ऑल नियर अराउंड रॉबर्ट हेरिक, यू नो. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैन रिमेंबर द नेम्स ऑफ द राइटर्स. नाउ द लास्ट यू नो पीरियड ऑफ द रेनेसां पीरियड इज द कॉमनवेल्थ पीरियड और द प्यूरिटन इंटररेग्नम एज यू नो इट. एंड इट बिगिंस फ्रॉम 1649 टू 1660, दैट इज ऑफ 11 ईयर्स. नाउ इट एक्सटेंड्स फ्रॉम द एंड ऑफ द सिविल वॉर एंड एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ चार्ल्स वन इन 1649 टू द रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ द स्टुअर्ट मोनार्की अंडर चार्ल्स द किंग सेकेंड इन 1660. सो इन दिस पीरियड England was ruled by Parliament under the Puritan leader Oliver Cromwell. His death in 1658 marked the dissolution of the Commonwealth. So friends, who were the famous writers of the Commonwealth period? So this is also known as Age of Milton. If M, Milton agar likhenge, to M ko agar hum ulta kar dete hain, to reverse it na, up mirror view, upside down. So you will get the letter W. So if the age of Milton, and the famous writer of this period was Isaac Walton. So Walton is there in this period. And then Milton's political pamphlets were very famous. Then there were writers like Thomas Brown, Thomas Fuller, Jeremy Taylor. These were some famous writers. And this period is also known as very important figures known as the age of metaphysical poets, where we see the poets like Abraham Cowley, Henry Vaughan, Edmund Waller, Andrew Marvell, John Donne, George Herbert, Thomas Trehan, and then Richard Crashew, and then all these metaphysical poets were there. So how will you remember? You remember Cow, Wow, Marvel, Wall, Herbert, Crash, Trasa, Traha. So Cow, Wow, Marvel, Wall, you can associate Cow, Wow. So Cow means Cowley, Wow means Vaughan. Then Marvel means, you know, Andrew Marvell, Wall means Edmund Waller. Then Herbert means, you know, George Herbert. Crash means Thomas, Richard Crashew. And then Traher means, Thomas Traheren. So this is how you remember the names. These are the some of the easy methods where you can remember the different names, because sometimes you feel that I will ever, it will be always restored in your soft disk here. This is not a hard disk, in a soft disk in the gray cells, but you forget it. So if you, this is one example, you can coin your own, formula for remembering the names, but I am giving you just the orientation. So cow wow means cow means Abraham Cowley, wow means Henry Vaughan. Then Marvel means Andrew Marvel, Wall means Edmund Waller, because Wall letter is hidden in that name. Then there is Herbert means George Herbert, and then Crash means Richard Crashew, and then Traher means Thomas Traherin. So that is what the important writers of this age. Now friends, I am coming to the next period, that is known as the Neoclassical period. And in this Neoclassical period, which begins from 1660 to 1700, can further be divided into three parts. So to remember the three different period under the Neoclassical period, or the three different ages under the Neoclassical period, that is of 125 years of duration, you remember one word, Raj. As you can see in the screen, Raj. The first R stands for the restoration that begins from 1660 to 1700. So since this Neoclassical period exactly begins from 1660 to 1785, but this restoration, Raj, the first letter of Raj is R, and R for restoration begins from 1660 to 1700. The rest 85 years of the Neoclassical period are further divided into two parts, that is Aj, A, the Augustan age, and J for age of Johnson, Dr. Johnson. So this is how you should remember the names. So you can see the restoration period begins from 1660 to 1700. That is a 40 years duration. And it takes its name from the restoration of the Stuart line king, that is Charles II, to the English throne in 1660. That is why, since the throne was restored, it is known as the restoration period. And it is the end of the Commonwealth period, which I had discussed in the previous slide. Now, in the Augustan age, that is R, Raj ka A, A for Augustan. Augustan is also known as age of Pope. That begins from 1700 to 1745. That is for the complete 45 years. No, so abhi 40 saal ka aur hisab baki hai, aur wo humko age of Johnson mein milega. So age Augustan age ko Augustan age kyun bolte hain friends? As I had told you in my previous video, there was a King Augustus from 27 BC to 1400 AD. That is why this period is also known as Augustan age, because the writers of this age like Alexander Pope and all, they revived that fashion of writing, that classical way of writing. That is why it is also known as Neoclassical, and they themselves called themselves as Neoclassicists. So that is one of the reasons, as you know, that during the reign of this King Augustus, there were three very prominent writers of that time. Those writers, if we want to remember, you just remember one word, H-O-V. It is not H-I-V, H-O-V. Horace, then Ovid and Virgil. These were the three writers who were the main prominent figures of the classical period of the Augustan, real Augustan age. So these writers influenced the writers of the Augustan age in 18th century, that is from 1700 to 1745, which is also comes under the umbrella of the Neoclassical period. Now, the third, that is J for age of Johnson, or age of Dr. Johnson, or otherwise is known as age of sensibility. So this period begins from 1745 to 1785, and here completes the complete Neoclassical period. So this is friend. Now, let me discuss some of the important features and writers of this period. The neoclassical period, as I told you, begins from 1660 to 1785. The first is the Raj of restoration of the key word that I have made you, Raj, to make you remember. I have coined the word Raj, this R for restoration period, that is of 40 years, 1660 to 1700. So the drama, as Joyner proposed, the comedy of manners was very famous, and restoration comedies were written in this period. And the main figure was Sir John Dryden, Sir George Etherege, William Wycherley, then William Congreve, and the main dramas were written like heroic drama, the distinctive form of tragedy written under Dryden and Otway. So if you want to remember the names, in John Dryden there is the word dry, and George Etherege there is the word ether, then William Wycherley, when there was curly, and then the William Congreve, when there was Kong. So this is how we can remember the names. But the main, you know, prose writers of this period, for that you remember this figure. There is a temple you can see, which is having under the roots of, surrounded by peepal tree, the religious tree. So you can see in this prose I have written locked banyan tree near temple. So this locked stands for John Locke of this prose writer, then banyan stands for John Bunyan, and Sir William Temple stands for the temple, and Samuel stands for poppy. So poppy person is there in the peepal tree, and have the kind of, you know, you just imagine that they, one poppy has there before the temple to, you know, lament and confess his sins and purify himself, to confess his, you know, sins. So you can remember Sir William Temple, John Bunyan, John Locke. So this is how you can remember the names. Now friends, we will see the second part of the neoclassical period, that is of Raj. We'll cover the letter A, and that A stands for Augustan Age. R stood for restoration, that we covered earlier. Now I am going to discuss you A for Augustan Age. So this is also known as Age of Pope. Alexander Pope was a very prominent figure of this time. And this begins from 1700 to 1745, that is of 45 years. Now, as I had talked about, that if you want to remember the, you know, three prominent figures, as HOV was there for the Augustus writers during the period of Augustan Age, Horace, Ovid, Virgil, HOV. Likewise, there were three prominent figures of the Augustan Age, and they were APS. APS stands for Addition, Pope, and Swift. So this APS, IPS ke jagah pe you have to remember APS, Addition, Pope, and Swift. These were the three prominent figures of this Augustan Age that comes under the umbrella of the neoclassical period. Now the theme of these writers were the social concerns, moderation, and decorum. Now how to remember? And there were three prominent genres of writers of this period, were novelists, journalists, and pamphleteers. So basically, dramatists were not in prominent lead role. The main were novelists, journalists, and pamphleteers. Now, who were the famous writers of this period? Daniel Defoe, Didi, then Lady Mary Montagu, and then Samuel Richardson. These were the famous writers of this period. Now, friends, I am going to discuss the third part of the neoclassical period, that is the J part of the Raj, and the period is known as J for Age of Johnson, and also known as the Age of Sensibility, which begins from 1745 to 1785, that covers complete 40 years. Basically, Pope dies in 1744 and Dr. Samuel Johnson comes in the scene, and his circle, Oliver Goldsmith, Gibbon, Edmund Burke, and James Boswell, ruled the era. So how do you remember these words, these writers, Oliver Goldsmith, Gibbon, Edmund Burke, and James Boswell? You just remember GG, BB. GG for Goldsmith and Gibbon, and BB for Burke and Boswell. Now the four wills of the English novelists, because this was the era from where the novel as a genre for the first time came into existence with the rise of the middle class, because earlier there were no middle classes and there were no novels, because the lower classes were satisfied the road streets and dramas, and the upper classes were satisfied the court dramas written by William Shakespeare and writers like that, or the university wits. But novel came with the emergence of the middle class, and middle class came into emergence with the Industrial Revolution. So there were no novels written earlier. Till the middle class was not there, novel was not in the history of English literature. It registered itself with the emergence of the middle class. So the four wills of the English novels were there in the 18th century, and during the age of Johnson, they rose and they registered their presence. The famous writer or the novelist of this time was Samuel Richardson, because he wrote the novel Clarice and Pamela, or The Virtue Rewarded is another subtitle of this novel. So it was written in 1740. Then Henry Fielding came with Joseph Andrews, the novel with Joseph Andrews. Then Lawrence Stern wrote the book Tristram Shandy in 1759, and Tobias Smollett wrote the book The Adventures of Peregrine Pickle that came into 1751. So friends, how would you remember these four great novelists, or the four wills of English novels popularly known as? How would you remember them? So just remember Richfield, Stern, Small. You can see in a picture I have put there. Richfield, Stern, Small means rich for Samuel Richardson, Field for Henry Fielding, and Stern for Lawrence Stern, and Small for Smollett. So this is how we can remember these four writers. So remember Richfield, Stern, Small. Richfield, Samuel Richardson. Field means Henry Fielding. Stern means Lawrence Stern, and Small means Tobias Smollett. So this is how we remember the names. Now friends, the Romantic period that begins with 1785 and 1832. The major poets of this time were the Coleridge, William Wordsworth, Keats, Shelley, Byron, and the major novelists were Jane Austen, Mary Shelley, Sir Walter Scott. So these were some of the famous writers of the prominent figures of this period who totally rent the period. Then in Romantic period we see that apart from these poets and novelists, we have a huge range of Gothic romances, they were written by Horace Walpole. They were the romantic in Gothic novels. We are having two categories. One is dominated by male, another is dominated by female. By male, some of the prominent male writers of this period is Horace Walpole, William Beckford, Matthew Gregory Lewis, William Godwin. And some of the female writers were Anne Radcliffe, who wrote Mysteries of Udolpho, and Mary Shelley, who wrote Frankenstein, and Clara Reeve, who wrote Old English Baron. So friends, it is assumed that many female writers were also writing Gothic novels, because Sigmund Freud says that since women were not given freedom, so some sexual expressions were also found in their tacit, were found in their works to vent out the things. So that is why some female writers in horror or the Gothic romances, you can see there, have played a prominent roles. So who are the famous writers? Horace Walpole, who wrote Cashel of Otranto, then William Beckford, Matthew Gregory Lewis is also known as Monk Lewis because his major work The Monk was so famous. Then there is William Godwin, and then there is Annie Radcliffe, then Mysteries of Udolpho, who wrote, and then Mary Shelley, then Clara Mary Shelley for the Frankenstein, and then Clara Reeve wrote the Old English Baron. Mary Shelley was sister of poet Shelley. Now this Victorian period begins from 1832 to 1901, and this period can be completely divided into two parts. The first part is the Pre-Raphaelites, that is from 1848 to 1860, and the aestheticians were the writers who came into 1880 in 1901, that is of 21 years they ruled. Now first I'll discuss the Victorian Pre-Raphaelites. These Pre-Raphaelites writers basically known for the seven member brotherhood. These were the writers who were basically they were painters, but those things who which were left in their emotions and they could not portray through the canvas, they were oozing out not through the paintings but through the words. Some of the emotions they expressed through their paintings and some of the leftover emotions they expressed through their write-ups. And their ideal was the Pre-Raphaelites. Raphael was a very prominent painter of the 15th and 16th century. So they were copying the painters before the Pre-Raphaelites. And those colorful emotions were also coming in their write-ups. Now this seven brotherhood, as you remember, begins from 1848 to 60. And the major writers or the seven member of this brotherhood, these seven writers clubbed together to form a group known as the Pre-Raphaelites. They were William Holman Hunt, then Thomas Woolner, then James Collinson, then Frederick George Stephens, then John Everett Malleus, then Dante Gabriel Rossetti, and then William Michael Rossetti. So friends, how would you remember the names? स्टीफेंस एवरेस्ट पर जाकर हंट करता है, कॉलिंस चढ़कर वुल निकालता है और जुड़वा रॉसेटी के साथ खेलता है. सो दैट इज़ हाउ विल यू रिमेंबर स्टीफेंस फॉर स्टीफन स्टीफेंस फॉर यू नो दिस फ्रेडरिक जॉर्ज स्टीफेंस, एवरेस्ट फॉर देन हंट फॉर विलियम हॉलमन हंट, देन कॉलिंस फॉर जेम्स कॉलिंसन एंड देन Wool for wool for Thomas Woolner, and then Rossetti for two Rossettis, that you can see Dante Gabriel Rossetti and William Michael Rossetti. So this is how we can remember the names: Thomas Woolner, Hunt, Collins and Stephens, Everett, Rossetti, then Dante Gabriel Rossetti and William Michael Rossetti. They were there in your fingertips because you have the formula. And you imagine the things, because to remember anything, you cannot do it unless until you memorize it practically and give some input to your mind, some input to your imagination. Otherwise, it is very difficult to remember anything. Now, friends, I am going to discuss the second part. The second part of the Victorian period is the aestheticians period, which begins from 1880 to 1901. And the famous poets of this period were the quartets, that is A, B, C, T. These four writers ruled the era of poetry during this Victorian period, and they were A, B, C, T. A for Arnold, B for Browning, C for Christina, and T for Tennyson. So, Christian Rossetti. So, this is how we have to remember the names: A, B, C, T. A for Arnold, B for Browning, C for Christina, and T for Tennyson. Now, the major fiction writers and dramatists of this period are Charlotte and Emily Bronte. They were the sisters. Then Dickens, Charles Dickens, is just like William Shakespeare of drama of the 16th century. Then William Macbeth Thackeray is, you can remember the name through the Indian political figure, Bal Thackeray, and the spelling of Thackeray is similar. There is no difference. Then George Eliot originally was Mary Ann Evans. She was a female writer, but she has a pen name of George Eliot. Middlemarch, you can never forget, written by her. Then Elizabeth Gaskell, then Thomas Hardy, then there was Anwell Butler and George Meredith. These were the famous writers of this era, that is the aestheticians of the Victorian period. Now, the period begins Edwardian period from 1901 to 14, and this is a period which is the span between the death of Queen Victoria in 1901 and the beginning of World War I, that is from 1940, and is named for King Edward II, and he reigned from 1901 to 1910. So since King Edward II ruled England at that time, so that is why this period is otherwise known as the Edwardian period. So the famous writers were the Thomas Hardy, Alfred Noyes, W.B. Yeats, William Butler Yeats, and then Rudyard Kipling was the famous writer, and the famous dramatists of this period are the Henry Arthur Jones, George Bernard Shaw, then Pinero. Pinero's The Magistrate was very famous, and then John Galsworthy. These were some famous dramatists of the period, and some of the prose writers like Thomas Hardy, Conrad Ford, Maddox Ford, and H.G. Wells and Henry James. So this is how we can never forget these writers, you know. So friends, next I am moving to the Georgian period, which is dedicated to the King George V, who ruled England at that time, and this period begins from 1910 to 36. The famous war poets, because that time the World War was there, 1914, one World War already we have seen. So a lot of war poets came into existence, and you can see there is a, you know, there is a Harley Davidson picture I have pasted here only because of your memory, because some of the famous writers of this period. First, let me read the names: Edward Marsh, Rupert Brooke, Walter de la Mare, W. H. Davis, then John Masefield, which sounds like Royal Enfield, Masefield, and then Henry Newbolt, and Thomas Hardy, Edward Thomas, A. Huntsman, and John Davidson. So these were some of the famous writers of this period. And you can remember through this, you know, this John Davidson through Harley Davidson, then John Masefield through Royal Enfield, then there is Newbolt, there the writer, then Thomas Hardy is there, was very hard, you know, then Thomas Brooke, then Walter de la Mare. So these are the famous writers of this period. And friend, this modern period begins from 1914, you know, and I have left it because it is still not known how much what is called modern. Is it we are in a postmodern world or a modern world? There is a, so I have left it open ended. Now, famous writers of this period is T.S. Eliot, W.H. Arden, Seamus Heaney, Graham Greene, Sonny Casey, and then Doris Lessing, and Samuel Beckett, Harold Pinter, Frank McGinnis. These are the famous writers, if you remember the names. There are many others, but since they are the flag bearers of their time, so I have written their names: T.S. Eliot, then W.H. Arden, then Seamus Heaney is there, then Graham Greene is there, then Sonny Casey is there, then Doris Lessing is there, Samuel Beckett, Harold Pinter, Frank McGinnis. These are the famous writers of this period. And then the last slide that I have is the postmodernism that begins from 1945, that is after the World War II. And the famous writers of the postmodern period are the Jean Baudrillard, these are the famous writer, Jean Baudrillard, then Jill Deleuze, then there is Jacques Derrida, deconstructionist, you know, then there is Michel Foucault, then there is Pierre-Félix Guattari, then there is Frederick Jameson, then there is Emmanuel Levinas, then there is Jean-François Letard, and then Richard Rorty, and then Slavoj Žižek. These are the famous writers who are coming under the section of postmodernism. And if you remember these names, I think, friends, it is more than enough. So what are the things that I have discussed? Different tips to remember the different periods. And I have given you I have thrown some of the names who were the flag bearers of their time, who were the leaders, who were the pioneers in their particular duration. So they have rent the world, and still their resonance is felt. So this is how the friends I have brought this, you know, different periods of literature with the different prominent writers. So I hope that it will help you to lay the foundation of English literature. Even if you have not read English in your BA, this particular video will give you a sound, you know, base to build up the castle further. Thank you very much, friends. Thank you very much.